It like you're okay. Stop judging yourself. Stop comparing yourself to other people's journeys. You are your own journey, and learn that this time is about becoming your inner authority and accepting yourself, being truthful with where you are, and making adjustments in your root chakras, your foundations, your stability, by accepting yourself where you are and really seeing what does not deserve your energy and time anymore, and being bold to make that transition. And what can you give more of your energy to that's actually been trying to come in? And that is so important for everyone to just meet themselves at that place. Okay, so the motivation to show up for something can be there, and it will be there. That's how we operate. We become motivated to make transitions or whatever. So the motivation and the intention can be there of what you're trying to accomplish, but what you need to do, or not need, but what to consider when you're creating the motivation or the intention around these things, is really just learning how to accept yourself where you're at is the starting point. Where it's like, okay, like ultimately I know that just by watching other people that there is a certain place that I can get to, or a certain level mm-hmm. that I can accomplish. But I really get there by, yes, being proactive, you know, being disciplined or whatever, you know, creating routines, that's true. But what all of that really means is you're just learning to learn yourself and accept yourself where you're at, and understanding that you're going to go on your own individual journey, and that it's really about going in and just accepting yourself where you're at, learning to love all components, both the shadow and the light, and understand everyone is the duality. Meeting yourself at that place, and then just keeping with the discipline and the routine of showing up for yourself, the action of going in the direction that you want to go. And it's going to change constantly. Because like one huge thing for me is I was vegan for like a solid 3 years. And I was like, I'm never going to eat meat again. Like, this is never going to happen. Blah, blah, on my little high horse. Like, doo, doo, doo. Anyways, I'm not an advocate for telling anyone how to eat. This is my personal journey, just so we're clear. Okay. Yeah. So no offense, anybody. But for me, I spent pretty much all of 2019 nomadic, traveling around the world and like moving around different states and whatever. So there was a lot of ungroundedness within my energy. Like I found myself just constantly being uprooted and having to adapt into new spaces energetically. And one thing I found very interesting that was coming up, because obviously, you know, we are constantly changing, was I started to feel my body's need to want to eat meat again, and like have this grounding component in my diet to keep me, especially with as much energy work that I do and going into those quantum fields every day. It was something that my body started asking for. And at first there was so much guilt and shame around that. I was like, I can't bring that back into my body. Like, what's going on? And I started to judge myself, and I started to think like, oh man, I must have really fallen far from the graces of God. Like, how could I be here again? And then I all of a sudden realized, oh, there's the problem.
Yeah.
I'm not accepting the truth of where I'm at and honoring what my body is telling me I need to do to just go on whatever journey I need to go on. And the real work has nothing to do with the external of what I'm eating and what I'm not eating. The real work is the acceptance of loving myself where I am.
Yeah.
You enjoying this so far? Did you forget to subscribe? Make sure to do so. It takes 2 seconds. Just press that little button, the red one. You know the one. Just press it, little like. All right, enjoy the rest of this content.
Where I am.
Yeah. And loving yourself where you're at, and as you were saying before, of how to like accept and be present is also like, yeah, is to be present and in the now, and mm-hmm. choose to want to do the things that you're doing. Yeah. Instead of a task list of to-dos that say, I need to get where I want to go.
Totally.
Like to say, yeah. I want to do this. I want to.
I deserve more. Instead of I'm so little that I need to be something else. I deserve more.
And then I'm already that person. Totally. I'm already that, you know, experience. But also, Yeah, that if you can take a step and be present, that anything worth doing is worth fully investing in and being present to, mm-hmm. and choosing the I want instead of I have to. And it's not that you're checking off to-do lists or you're forcing yourself into something, that you're really embracing it because it's what you want. Mm-hmm. And it's listening to yourself, like Annalise is saying, like, you know, like wherever you are is perfect. And
accepting yourself. Yeah. It's just accepting yourself. Like,
that's it.
Like, okay, so maybe I like to eat Pop-Tarts at night. Okay, this is something that's happened to me in quarantine. I don't know why, but I can't stop eating them. And I, you know, whatever, they're good. But the point is it just accepting yourself where you are? And actually, this is something that I learned from Matt Kahn, which is great if you guys want to check his videos out, where he really says, again, and I can't help but reiterate this too, and it's been such a beneficial tool in my life, it is so sound for operating, is just like laughing at yourself and not taking it so serious. And that is actually giving you a stronger foundation to be like, you know, there I go. Isn't this funny? Sneaking a Pop-Tart at midnight, you know, like getting crumbs all in my bed as I watch Indiana Jones. Like, this is real. And the thing is, instead of being like, oh, I'm a slob, or I can't believe I'm putting these impurities in my body, how dare I, just like start to acknowledge, like, maybe I don't want to do this. Maybe this isn't serving me. Maybe this isn't honoring me. Or maybe it is.
Yeah.
And that's, yeah. So just accepting yourself where you're at and bringing more love to those areas. And does that love will give you the energy to be like, I'm good on the Pop-Tarts. Like,
yeah.
I deserve more than that. Or maybe it's exactly what I deserve.
In essence, it's stop judging yourself and really allowing yourself to view these obstacles as opportunities and see where you go. Remember, your journey is your journey. This isn't a race of anywhere. And
there's no one way.
If you like this content, make sure that you like, subscribe, and comment below. And we also have amazing link right there for some cool product. I know you want to check it out. I know you want to click it. Go ahead. Come on. You can do it. All right. Until next time, have a beautiful, blessed day.